So we have a lot of brand new information to share in today's update and certain things that I really just want to clarify when it comes to the world of the unemployment lawsuits. So hey everyone, how's it going today? And welcome back to another third/fourth stimulus check unemployment benefits extension update. So the big thing to notice is that even though I do know, yes, the unemployment program is obviously about to lapse for millions and millions of people, millions of people around the entire country, and it's possible that if you're watching this in the future, maybe it is potentially actually already lapsed. But the big thing to really notice, and I know that it was a very common question, is that as long as these lawsuits are still going on, the most important thing is really going to be what happens at the very, very end when the lawsuit decisions are made and when the cases actually completely officially closes. This includes both the lawsuits and the appeal, because the big thing to notice is that everything that we are talking about is indeed going to be retroactive and actually has already been retroactive in a lot of the states that have one. So even if the unemployment lapses, the big thing to notice that it is still very, very possible. In fact, it already is happening that there are still many, many states that are still continuing the fight in order to try to bring back unemployment, and that if the case is able to be won, even if it happens after the unemployment has lapsed, because the unemployment programs are all retroactive, it does mean is that all of these payments will be returned retroactive since the date that your state actually officially ends if they are able to win the lawsuit. I do know, for example, I have brand new information about Ohio and several other states when it comes to what's been going on there, is because they are still very, very much fighting. So at least, even though I do know it's obviously been very, very difficult, it means that there is still some level of hope. So I think that's what I really, really want to talk about in today's update to hopefully clarify. I do maybe also really want to share, while as many of you guys are still here as possible, is that because obviously it has been a relatively, I know it's probably been a relatively emotional time. I know it's been probably a very, very relatively emotional week, especially intense because of everything that's been going on, is that regardless of whether you are watching this now or into the future, I do just also want to say a really, really huge thanks for every single person who really comes by, especially if you've been someone that's been actively really sharing information and sharing support and everything, because I do think is that it's really through a lot of the information that every single person shares, and feel free to share any today if you have any in particular that you want to share as well, that really does help to make all of the information easy to kind of organize and kind of to be able to find and share among one another. So I think every single person ultimately really, really does appreciate it. So if you guys have been here for a while, huge thanks and really huge love to every single person that comes by. So we're gonna run through everything, but as always, maybe real fast before we begin, remember to smash the like button, although you guys can decide, because obviously it's gonna be an, you know, it's been a relatively emotional, and I do know that. So consider subscribing if you guys are brand new here. Huge thanks, as mentioned, if you guys have been here for a while. And as always, feel free to comment any questions, thoughts about us, just really anything at all. So with that being said, let's get this video started right now on the spot. So being that this is probably going to be the final update before the unemployment lapse happens, right now at this current time, we currently have officially 15 states that have some kind of lawsuit going on, or that had some kind of lawsuit going on, to maybe finally organize it out there. I tried to remember them, but I think I'm just gonna read it off to cheat it a little bit in today's update. But ideally those 15 states, if you need a very fresh recap, is going to be Indiana, Maryland, Oklahoma, Texas, Florida, Ohio, Arkansas, South Carolina, Tennessee, Louisiana, West Virginia, Missouri, Alabama, Iowa, and then very, very recently New Hampshire, which just opened their lawsuit just a couple of days ago. So these are really the states that really have to just kind of follow along, especially if you are one of the states that recently did open their lawsuit. Now, when it comes to the maybe the first state that we're really going to be talking about, is really going to be about Ohio. So Ohio has a very interesting story, as most of you guys probably saw in one of the previous updates, which I believe is also called 15 states, because today is really just a build-up update of that update. But the idea really is that in Ohio, what's going on is that they recently ended up deciding that they will now at the very, very last minute open up not even one, but actually two lawsuits now that is going to be opened up in Ohio. So as in like two totally brand new lawsuits on top of everything that you have heard. The story to what really ended up, if you need a quick recap about Ohio, is that the great news is that Ohio was indeed able to win their appeal, and that the judge is trying to bring the unemployment back to the unemployed people in Ohio. But what happened is that essentially Governor DeWine, who is the governor of Ohio, he ended up actually deciding to fight the judge's decision after he lost the appeal, and he's now trying to take it to the even higher court now, but specifically the Supreme Court, in order to kind of overpower the judge's decision. So what's happening now is that the lawyer that's representing, so the law firm that represents in Ohio, his name is, or the law firm is Dan Law. What they're hoping to essentially do right now is that they now just recently opened another two brand new lawsuits. What these two new lawsuits are going to do is that the first lawsuit, as a last minute resort, is going to be aimed at trying to fight to represent the people in order to try to make one last attempt to get the unemployment back. But the second lawsuit that he's hoping to file is that he's hoping to now file a lawsuit in order to request money from the federal government to return some of the funds in order to help fund the unemployment system. Because this is something that actually is going on right now, which we're gonna talk about in Florida, which is why I kind of say the states are kind of linked in a little bit, is because in order to try to bring back the unemployment, what they ended up realizing is that they have to actually find a way to physically, logistically bring back the money. So what he's hoping to do right now in Ohio is that if they're able to finally try to actually specifically get the money that Biden approved inside of the third stimulus package back, they can maybe use that as a way to show that the money is officially ready, and that all we have to do now is get the judge to clear it so that they can officially try to deliver the money and send it back. And because keep in mind is that the lawsuits, the appeal has already been won, and the judge actually wants to, specifically the judge, the county judge who made the decision to grant the people who are unemployed in Ohio their appeal, does want to bring it back. It's just that he's being overpowered now. That's really the story to what's happening. Essentially, it's that the judge is actually on our side, but he's being fought on by Governor DeWine and his lawyer. So that's really the situation here that's going on here now. But there are now two new lawsuits that we have to see what's going on. Now, when it comes to the Supreme Court side, we haven't really heard information. So essentially, you can even say there's three things going on now. The two lawsuits and then the Supreme Court situation that's going on with the case between Governor DeWine in Ohio, and then of course the unemployment people, and then of course also the judge that is trying to now help the unemployed people bring it back. The judge's name is Judge Holbrook. Now, this kind of leads on to the second state that we're really going to be talking about, which is going to be Missouri. Now, the story with Missouri is that maybe one hard news to share is that Missouri actually did end up recently getting results, and they actually did not win their lawsuit. So I know it is going to come as a little bit of a heartbreak. The reasoning is actually very similar to Florida, which is the reason that we're, which what we're going to explain in a little bit about what happened is that essentially is that they tried to put in their lawsuit. Now, it is very unclear if Missouri is going to be doing any kind of appeal because we just got our results. It is believed, however, that in Florida they will be trying to do an appeal. Of course, because the appeal doesn't exist yet, it's unconfirmed, but it is believed by many that they will be doing it. So I guess going on to the next state, which we're going to talk about, is really going to be Florida. So most people probably already know the decision results about what happened in Florida, which is the fact that Governor DeSantis sadly did end up actually blocking, and sadly it was not won in Florida when it comes to the lawsuit to bring back unemployment. It is believed that there is going to be an appeal. However, right now at this time, it's unconfirmed. However, there are a lot of people that were hoping to kind of clarify some details about what really ended up happening in Florida. So really the big story to what happened in Florida is that in Florida, the judge that represented the case, or the judge that made the decision in that case, Judge Lane Smith, the more detailed story is that he pretty much ended up writing an 18-page set of notes claiming, or essentially making his statement to what he believes about the current situation. And according to him, what he believes is that he sided, actually sadly, with Governor DeSantis, believing is that the unemployment should end because it's going to help to promote job growth and solve the high unemployment rates that's currently happening over there. Which is ironic because it's actually been about a month now, and so far, I'm pretty sure it's actually been proven actually by concrete research that unemployment rates actually haven't really changed at all in basically not even just Florida, but actually in the majority of states that have actually ended unemployment. So it's probably been well known that a lot of this has actually been going against what they stated, but that's just simply put what they've stated as their statement. And then the second big reason why the judge ended up actually siding with his decision was because he believes and argued in his statement that essentially it was that because the unemployment had already actually physically ended, that was the reason why he actually believed that maybe it was not even a right thing, but it was actually because of that reason that it was actually logistically not possible for them to bring the unemployment. Now, we obviously know that that is not true because Indiana was able to reinstate and get their unemployment back. There were other states that managed to do it, but the idea is that that's just simply put the statement that he wants to make. Essentially, he is saying is that because he sees the pandemic in his eyes, he's stating that because he feels that the pandemic is of course recovering, he sees that the job is growing, jobs are starting to come back again, and he feels because the logistics is going to make it difficult to be able to do it, that is the reason why he was not able to grant unemployment back in Florida. So it's not to say that it's true or not. You guys can feel free to share your particular opinions, but that's pretty much the statement that the judge left to explain why he made the decision that he made, which is ironic because not him, but another judge actually also just made a decision in Florida, interestingly, apparently requiring mask mandates in schools. I think there was supposedly a lawsuit that people were fighting about trying to require mask mandates in schools, and apparently they did actually win that. So it's kind of ironic is that they're requiring mask mandates, but at the same time is that they, in that situation, it kind of makes it seem like the pandemic is getting better, yet at the same time they're ending unemployment. But that's pretty much really the story that's going on right there right now. So hopefully that kind of clarified and shared information about what's been going on right now. But the overall big thing to notice is that I think that even though, yes, I do know it's very, very difficult, but with a lot of these lawsuits still going on, I think the big thing to notice is that there is still some level of hope. I know it's difficult, but at least it still exists. And that's the most important thing. And I think at the end of the day, the big thing to notice is that this really was something with millions of people really, really in it together. And I think at the end of the day, most of us, certainly whether it came to the lawsuits or things that happened, I think most of us, we really did try our best. And I think that's really the most important thing. Of course, at the end of the day, we can only really do so much. So hopefully this, you know, becomes some glimmer of something brighter to come. But of course, at the end of the day, just have to really take it a day at a time. So with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. Stay safe, stay well. If you are watching this on release day, have a really, really great, safe, blessed. I know it maybe is difficult, but maybe just try to have a really relatively great, safe, blessed Labor Day weekend. And with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. As always, stay safe, stay well, and hope to see you guys next time. Thank you guys so much again.